Hi there, I'm James Dapperty, and this is Coffee and a Case Note. Team, today we're going to be speaking about an application for judicial advice from a trustee in circumstances where we have an absent trust deed. Thank you very, very much. And there's an application made for advice from the court pursuant to Section 63 of the Trustee Act here in New South Wales. And the nature of an application of that kind is that you will put before the court what essentially amounts to a yes-no question. You as a trustee, and this is available to insolvency practitioners as well, will come before the court and say, hey court, I've got a proposed course of action. I want to do 1, 2, 3, and 4. Could I please get your advice as to whether I would be justified in doing so? And that's the nature of today's application. The trustee has an absent trust deed. Sometimes we speak about lost trust deeds. Here, the evidence doesn't disclose a trust deed really at all, and we can't really put our finger on it. And so the trustee is coming to the court with a certain proposed course of action. And so what are we dealing with here? We have a trust that appears to have been settled in around about 1982. We've got a pair of spouses, and it appears that those spouses are the beneficiaries of the trust. Spouse one appears to be the settlor of the trust, appears to have provided in the early 1980s the relevant assets and that sort of thing to really get the trust set up and established and underway. Spouse one, forgive me, dies in about 2014. Spouse two dies in about 2022, and an administrator is appointed to spouse two's estate. But we still have the trustee company in place, and the trustee company remains owner of these assets and is coming before the court to say, I don't have a trust deed to dictate how I'm meant to run this trust, and so I need some advice. Now, often when we deal with lost trust deed cases, we have a little more evidence than this. Sometimes we don't have the original trust deed and we've got a photocopy. Sometimes we don't have sibling three's trust deed, but we've got the identical trust deeds for sibling one's trust, sibling two's trust, and sibling four's trust with the same trustee, and we invite the court to make an inference. So often there is more evidence than what we have today. Here we have is the complete non-existence of a trust deed. And so the court is forced to have a look at the way the trust was run over time. And it appears that over time that it was treated as if spouse one and spouse two were the beneficiaries of the trust. There were distributions made, the tax records reflect this, that over time we've got money being distributed from the trust to spouse one and spouse two. But the court takes judicial notice or considers it common knowledge that where there is what we'll call a family trust, where you know potentially principal spouses will be the beneficiaries, then it's almost inevitable that there will be other beneficiaries as well, kids, nieces, nephews, whatever it may be. And so here, the trustee is in a position of saying, well, I actually don't have the deed that would say niece one, nephew two, and niece three are the other potential beneficiaries of this trust. And so the court is left to consider this situation. And what the court finds is that the trust fails. And the trust fails because it fails to satisfy the certainty of object test, right? It is unclear who is to be a beneficiary of this trust. And so that is it for the trust. And so the trustee following this line and seeking the advice of the court says, right, if the trust fails, then a resulting trust arises to benefit spouse one. Because remember, it's spouse one's assets that were deposited into the trust. They were the settlor of the trust. Spouse one died in 2014. Spouse two was the sole beneficiary of spouse one's trust. So the trustee is saying spouse one's assets should go to spouse two. But don't forget, spouse two has passed away as well. And so there is an interim administrator appointed to administer spouse two's estate following spouse two's death. And the short point is that the trustee gets the judicial advice they came for. The nature of that judicial advice is yes, the trustee would be justified in paying the money that they're holding in trust straight into the account or straight into the hands of the interim administrator of spouse two's deceased estate. So as I said before, judicial advice is coming before the court, essentially seeking a yes-no answer to a proposed cause of action. here, the trustee came before the court, made that proposal, the proposed course of action on the basis of the failure of the trust for the certainty of object position, and the court said, tick, yes, you can have your advice. Yes, you'd be justified in making that payment. I hope that discussion assisted you, and I look forward to joining you again soon over another coffee and in respect of another case note. Cheers.